Damilola Olusegun. I've been doing this for close to 3 years now. I started 2016, but professionally I started 2017. 2016, I was still taking it as like fun. I've not taken it professionally to a professional level. So I started professionally at 2017. And that was like 3 years to 4 years for now. What inspired me at first was my dad. Because initially, all through those 2016, he just gave me that motivation, to start, take my pencil and start something. Though then I had the love for it, but so I was not really deep like that. But when I later lost him at that late 2016, I wanted to stop at first, but 2017, I just sat down and rethink about it, and I was like, I can't just let this man's legacy to just die like that. That's why I just picked it up 2017 fully. I would say what makes me really unique is that, one, I work on big sizes, because I've checked, I searched all through internet, I've checked artists both in Nigeria and overseas. But what I notice mostly in Nigeria is that we artists, we work mostly on almost the same aspects. But I was like, I don't want to do the same thing. I don't want to do the same thing with everybody. So I just had this love for big sizes, enlargements, sizes like 6 feet, 4 feet. And when I work on small sizes, it's like I'm caged. But when I work on big sizes, like I'm given the freedom to express myself. My works focus on emotional feelings, almost all my works, because I feel like through art, you'll be able to pass through messages, you'll be able to touch lives. There are some times that you see some artworks and you'll be like, they don't even need to tell you anything. When you see the artwork, you already know that this artwork is saying something to me. This artwork is passing a message through to me. I call my work hyperrealism, and sometimes I do photorealism and realism. As we all know, the situation of Nigeria right now, especially in art, is only someone that is really passionate about what he or she does that can really struggle with it and just endure everything that is going on. Because when I started art at first, the situation of Nigeria wanted to pull me back. We can see in Nigeria recently now, we are starting to see the value of art. And I know that if we can continue like that, it will get to a stage that art will be very, 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 very much valued in this country. One of the challenges is that you don't get enough clients. And again, our works are underpriced. Like, because we artists, when we work, we don't think about, most of the times, I don't think about the materials, though it is important. But what I think mostly about is the time I put into my work. The knowledge I put into it, it is priceless. It is priceless. And when it comes out, all we hear is wow, wow, wow. And that wow is not enough. It's not enough. As an artist, you will know, you will feel it. You feel that wow is not enough. We need to value it more in this country. We shouldn't be underpriced. We shouldn't be looked like, we shouldn't look at us like. Sometimes if you tell something that you are doing, as you'll feel like, you don't want no art, no one's in the art. This art is supposed to be very, very much. But if we can value art very well in Nigeria, trust me, we will know that we've been missing a lot out of art. One of them is getting materials. Art materials are expensive. That's one of the things that chases artists, like upcoming artists. But most of my materials in there, for example, no, I didn't get them at first. So what I tell most artists recently is that it's not compulsory you get all your materials at once. Come up with it gradually. Before you know it, when you look at your materials, you'll be like, wow, I've gotten this so much materials. One of them is materials. That's one of them is time. Art takes a lot of time. And that time, you have to be, as in, you must not be distracted when you are working again as an artist. Because once you are distracted, your mind will shift away from what you are doing. Before you know it, you'll start doing rubbish. Sometimes if you get tired of the work. Art competition is very poor in Nigeria. You hardly see art competitions in Nigeria. Art competitions should be also valued in Nigeria because it's very, very low, like, let me say, like 10% or 20%. There are some works that are really, really detailed, but at least, I spend weeks. I can spend like 2 weeks on a work, 3 weeks on a work, and again, it depends on how big it is, like I said earlier. In a day, at least, I work 8 hours. most of my works recently, they focus on self-discovery. They focus on relationship, they focus on being connection, they focus on motherhood also, and they focus on, will I call it child death or something like childhood, something that is related to, it's just that something that is related to self, to yourself and the person you are partnering with. I also noticed that there's something that is common in Nigeria that really should be stopped or should be reduced. Connection. In everything now, you must have connection in Nigeria to be able to get there. Even as an artist too, you must have connection. Even all those art galleries that are out there, you must have connection to be able to put your artworks out there. Even the exhibitions, most of the exhibitions, you must have connection for you to be able to put out. Even if there's even competition, I believe that they even use connection for that too. Because there are some competitions that I put in for in Nigeria, and the works are not even, the works you see that they later pick, they are not even, as in, it's not like they are not okay. But I test them again with competitions outside Nigeria, and I feel like, and they accept them. I'm not like, these artworks, why are they always like, isn't that the people that they are supposed to pick that are more than enough? Or, but I feel that connection is another thing. That's why in Nigeria they say it's always every time. If you don't have connection in Nigeria, you cannot get there. They say it's a loss, and it is true. It is true. It is not something that should be hidden, and it should be stopped, or it should just be reduced. Government should invest more in arts, like build more art galleries. My dream is to own a very big art gallery, explore my works, pass through messages to other people, tutor artists, upcoming artists that are ready to learn, that they are really passionate about what I do.